Hi, I'm Dr. Lee, a spine surgeon at Johns Hopkins Orthopaedic Surgery. I'm going to talk about complex endoscopic spine surgeries more than simple disc surgeries. I have nothing to disclose related to this topic. Endoscopic spine surgeries have been for simple disc surgeries, but we have more conditions like recurrent disc herniation or thoracic spine disc, and the spinal stenosis more commonly, and some patients need the spine fusion procedures. For the last several years, endoscopic spine surgeries have started to cover this kind of complex conditions. Let me show you several cases. This is a recurrent disc herniation. Conventional approach is going back again, open the muscle, remove the bone and ligament and joint, and take the disc out. Sometimes we need a fusion surgery because of extensive bone resection, but we did the endoscopic approach. It's not going to the back again. Instead, we access the spine from the outside and shape the bone from the outside of the spine and expose the nerve root and disc herniation very safely. And this is the surgical video, the operating room. So it can visualize the disc herniation and nerve root very well. So these are the pictures showing the ruptured disc fragment and the skin incision, the old midline skin incision and the new endoscopic 7mm incision. So next case is thoracic spine disc herniation 8 and 9. It's a pinching spinal cord here. Traditional procedure is going to midline, open the muscle, cutting the ligament and bone, laminectomy, and put screws and fusions. But with a small narrow walking sleeve with endoscopic procedure, we could access the disc herniation and spinal cord well, and we could decompress the spinal cord very safely without extensive exposure or some surgical fusion procedures. Okay, and this is the skin incision. It's a little bit off center of the spine with a 7mm working incision. This patient has a lumbar spinal stenosis with a ruptured disc. It's about migration. This is the MRI. We did the endoscopic decompression procedure as identical to the open procedure, like a laminectomy above and below, and decompression of the ligaments, compressing the nerve structure at the central part, and until we make a good decompression is the same, like open laminectomy procedure. And we can access all the way out to the other side of the spine, and we can remove the disc herniation and the foraminal decompression until we can see the nerve root into the other side. So in terms of meticulous decompression, this is better than open conventional decompression procedures. So this is a nerve root on the other side. And this is the intraoperative x-rays. It shows we can access the other side of the spine very nicely. But the last case is this patient has a big disc herniation with underlying severe spinal stenosis, but needed a fusion surgery because of unstable L4-5 joint. So with endoscopic approach, we can finish the decompression procedure. It's also very similar like open procedure, but everything is done by a 7mm working sleeve with the endoscopy. So cutting the bony spur and the ligament and any structures, pushing the nerve structure, and can finish the decompression, then clean the fusion bed and place the screws and cages and bone graft to finish the fusion process. And this is the limb of the disc material, and this is the surgical incision, and 1 inch on both sides. Okay, this is still showing the decompression procedure with endoscope. So now we can visualize the nerve structure very well. This shows good decompression. Endoscopic spine surgery has very strong advantages, like smallest skin incision, least tissue damage and blood loss, and minimal surgical pain and early recovery. And these are not sour grapes anymore with modern advanced endoscopic surgical techniques. We'll do the best to provide the highest level of spine care at Johns Hopkins. If you or your patient need more information or have any questions, you can contact my information. We can provide more information in detail. Thank you very much.